Nearly everybody's vision in 2020 is blurry. It's continuing to look a lot like Germany in the 30s. History doesn't repeat, but it rhymes fairly clearly. The similarities are very eerie. Militarily, we spend $1 trillion yearly. But it isn't really we who spend it, we merely pay dearly. But not nearly as much as the people of Afghanistan, Iraq, Palestine, Libya, Yemen, and Syria. Listen to them, not Alexa or Siri. I don't mean to be all dreary in your earpiece, but humanity can't stand much more trauma and sheer grief. Fools feel more empathy for the president and his ostentatious shams than they do for refugees and immigrants being kept in concentration camps.
Y'all don't feel nothing?
Fuck a line in the sand.
Y'all get sick and comfortable?
We got to make a stand.
And think you and dude some kind of, Are y'all crazy? So I say to you today, don't think for 1 minute that you can educate yourself away from it. Don't think you can money yourself away from it. Okay? And y'all go on and play your game and think you can educate your little children to peacefully coexist with a filthy system. You don't care about it because you don't know it. You're going to pay for that just like the Germans paid for it, not knowing what them Nazis was doing. This last election, that's a child.
This 4D chess is the same old story, more or less. Every nation claims to be glorious and teaches kids the historical equivalent of top 40 hits, enforcing chlorinated fake olds. I'm trying to make this flow, break my own stable mode that I've settled into just a little. Lately though, it creates on its own. I'm like some crazy old radio just picking up the signal. Breath control means using both lungs. Where I'm from, where it's all about the kick and snare drum, plus the hi-hat. Dive into the wax to find that hip-hop rockers jazz. My grasp is wider than IMAX. Lifetimes flying by too fast to let blind bastards call lies facts while they chatter all lives matter. As if we can't see that when it comes to black lives, they damn sure don't act like that. They want you to think schools were infested with leftist hippies, cause it's hard to get close to a 4.0 and still wanna take you back to the 50s. Feels like it's the 60s again, and the 70s, and especially the 80s with the presidential professional wrestling. It's just the kind of beats and rhymes you see from 93 in my prime. I'm getting closer slowly, still far from practicing it all the time entirely, but finding that sobriety is the most high I can be.
For defusing evil empires, acquiring human beings, conjuring with a mouse, moving over the weakest green it seems. Mr. Sandman is giving nightmares instead of the American dream. It's not apparently, it's a guarantee. We got a demon trying to lead this nation to a lack of lit kerosene, but faith in the people to still take care of things to make it right. Kick to the fight where we unite. He's so bad for tribal lands, it's blowing up sacred sites. For the dumbest idea of a wall reaching a certain height. There's generations of honor treating that's being spiked, and that's only tip of the toxic of what this poison's like. He's the cause of over 200,000 deaths in this country, without another single country wanting to call the fight. So he's definitely and literally the epitome of a silly soliloquy, hiding in plain sight, and continues resuming the figure of that bigot type, right?
Now we can see what it is. Empires are enormously profitable, mostly for the ruling class. Empires are also enormously costly, mostly for the common populace. The people of Rome didn't do too well on the empires. They got a grain goal and that was it. They often paid the price in blood. They were piled up in tenements and night. And that's the truth of every empire. The empire feeds off the resources of the republic. That was true of the Roman Empire in its days, right to the late republic. That was true of the British Empire, and that's true today. The people pay the taxes and do without essentials so that the patricians can pursue their far-off plunder. The center is bled so that the perimeter can expand. We pay for that. Every community in this country pays that. I go all over this country speaking, and I pick up the papers, and it often looks like this. I'm in the same place every time, the same story every time. City council votes cuts in the budget. State legislature facing large deficit. This and that. School closed. closing, libraries closing, hospital closing, lack of funding, so forth, so on. The empire feeds off the republic. Somebody's got to pay for that. Where is all the money going, everyone's asking? Well, for some people, empire is quite profitable.
Wondering what one or two of your most favorite Bible verses are.
Well,
and why.
I wouldn't want to get into it because to me that's very personal. You know, when I talk about the Bible, it's very personal. So I don't want to get into
There's no verse that means a lot to you that you think about or cite.
The Bible means a lot to me, but I don't want to get into specifics.
Even to cite a verse that
no,
you like.
No, I don't want to do that.
You're Old Testament guy or a New Testament guy?
Probably equal. I think it's just an incredible. The whole Bible is an incredible. I joke. Very much so. They always hold up the Art of the Deal. I say my second favorite book of all time. But I just think the Bible is just something very special.